story about Sister Isabel and I. You see, last May 2014, so a year ago, I received a phone call in my mom's office. And the voice on the other end said, "Dear, this is Sister Isabel. It would be great if you could come to the convent. There's something that I want to show you." I said, "Okay, sister." And I put down the phone and I turned to my mom and I said, "Mom, who's Sister Isabel?" We had never met, but she always treats people like she's known them forever, right? I'm sure a lot of you can attest to that. So I went to the convent, and she laid out all of these documents, these phrases, and these sentences, and PowerPoint slides, and pictures, like puzzles, pieces of a puzzle that didn't really make sense on their own, but made sense when you put it all together. But it wasn't all together yet. And she turned to me and she said, "I want to turn this into a book." I said, "Okay." And that was the start of it. So we would meet every week, and we would meet for a couple of hours every day, once a week. And she would tell me her stories. And I would record everything and then write them down and then the next week read them back to her. And that's kind of the process that we had going into the book. But I felt so blessed to be entrusted with her stories. And she really opened up during our sessions. That was so beautiful for me to witness. It amazed me how this woman could be so vulnerable, could allow herself to be so exposed in many ways. When she was in Africa, this would be in the form of giving of herself to everybody that she would meet. And then even when she came back, it was being vulnerable in the sense that she would share her stories with different communities. I mean, she didn't know how people would receive it, but she was just so willing to give of herself and willing to be vulnerable. But at the same time, she's also a pillar of strength to so many people in Africa and here in the Philippines. And I realized that that's because, for those of you who have read the book or thinking about reading the book, she is a lot like the seeds that she planted, the jacaranda seeds that she planted in Africa. She just allowed herself to be planted wherever God chose to put her, and she bloomed wherever she was planted, because God was her gardener and her life source, her oasis. And so today, we celebrate Sister Isabel and a life lived in adventure, a life lived in service to others, and a life lived on a mission. And she'll tell you that it's all because of God that she was put here. It's all because of God that she was able to share. But really, none of this would have been possible if not for her willingness to be used by God in the way that He has used her. Congratulations, Sister Isabel. I hope you enjoy your day.